Hello children, this was 7th standard science. You need 2 in physics, electricity. Yes, it's a very interesting lesson. We can see the lesson in detail now. Okay, first we'll see the learning objectives. Understanding the flow of electric current and learning to draw the circuit diagram. Understanding the difference between conventional current and electron flow. Understanding the different types of circuit based on flow of electricity and the connection of bulbs in a circuit. Distinguishing a cell and a battery. Understanding the effects of electric current and factors affecting the effect of electric current. Applying their knowledge in identifying the components of electrical circuits. Understanding the discrimination between different types of circuits. Doing numerical problems and drawing the circuit diagram of their own. We'll see up to different types of circuit based in this video. Okay children, are you ready to listen the class? I hope you have undergone this lesson, electricity, in 6th standard itself. Here, the explanation is little bit vast. Okay, already you know each and every term. I hope you know each and every term in electricity. Yes children. Yes, so in 1882, in New York City, Thomas Alva Edison pushed the switch on. So 14,000 bulbs in 9,000 houses suddenly got lighted up. So it was the greatest invention to mankind. So you think for 1 second, if there is no electricity, yes, how will you manage? Without electricity, nowadays, in present situation, we can't run our life even for 1 or 2 hours, isn't it? And even during summer time, you think in the daytime, the power is off for 2 hours. Imagine what will be. Yes? So, it is very hard if there is no electricity. So, Thomas Alva Edison, he invented the electricity. From then the world was under the light even in the night. So this electricity came to India in 1899, 17 years after the New York. In 1899 only electricity first came to India. The Calcutta Electric Supply Corporation Limited commissioned the first thermal power plant in India on 17th April 1899. So first, before going to see about electricity, first we have to know what are all the subatomic particles present in an atom. What are proton, what are neutron, what is electron? First you should understand that one. Already in chemistry, yes, we have seen what is matter. What is matter? Anything in the universe which occupies space and has mass, we call that as matter. So matter, atoms and molecules are building blocks of matter. So what is atom? Atom is the smallest particle which can take part in a chemical reaction. Okay, so what are the subatomic particles? Proton, electron and neutron. Yes, proton, electron and neutron. What is the charge of proton? What is charge of electron and charge of neutron? So charge of proton is positive charge. Charge of electron is negative charge. Neutron is not having any charge. It is neutral in nature. So if you take the structure of an atom, at the center, nucleus will be present. Inside the nucleus, proton and neutron will be present. Outside the nucleus, electron will be present. Yes? Isn't it, children? Is it clear now? So here, one experiment is given. You will play with this experiment, I hope. Yes, you will understand it in a clear manner. So you have to take one comb. Yes, and you have to comb your hair, dry hair. Yes, so if you do it fastly and if you keep it near the bits of paper, the bits of paper will be attracted by means of comb, isn't it? So, when a body is rubbed against some other body, it becomes charged. So, electric charge is measured in a unit called coulomb. So when you rub any substance, yes, when you rub any substance, the charges which are present in that substance, okay, the charges present in that substance, it will start to move. So that we call it as electric charge. So electric charge is measured in a unit called coulomb. One unit of coulomb is charge of approximately 6.242 into 10 to the power of 18 protons or electrons. So electrical charges are generally denoted by the letter Q. So now we'll see electric current. So the flow of electric charges constitute an electric current. Flow of electric charges constitute in an electric current, there will be a electric charges will be present. That electric charges will be flowing. The flow of electric charge, we call that as electric current. If you switch on, yes, that time the electric charge will be started to move. So that we call it as electric current. So for an electrical appliance to work, electric current must flow through it. So electric current is measured by the amount of electric charge moving per unit time. Unit time means 1 second, 1 minute, 1 hour, like that. Okay, per unit time at any point in the circuit. Yes, if you take the whole circuit at any point, it will be moving. So the conventional symbol for current is I. The conventional symbol for current is I. So this picture is given like cylinder-like as a substance is given. That substance is having the cross-section area. Yes, so the charges which is in the movement, we call that as electric charge. So now we'll see what is unit of electric current. So the SI unit for measuring an electric current is the ampere, yes, which is the flow of electric charge across the surface at the rate of 1 coulomb per second. So coulomb is the measuring of electric charge. So electric current I is equal to Q by T. Electric current I is equal to Q by T. So where I is the electric current, which is measured in terms of ampere. Q is the electric charge, which can be measured in the unit of coulomb. And T is the time taken in seconds. So in the triangle, it is given current, charge and time. Clear, children? So what is the formula? I is equal to Q by T, where I is the electric current. The unit of electric current is ampere, Q is the charge, unit is coulomb, and T is the time taken, the unit is seconds. So here, in worked example is given, that is, they are asking to calculate the current in the wire. So you know the formula, I is equal to Q by T. So Q is nothing but here, 30 coulomb of electric charge. So 30C divided by 2 minutes. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 2 minutes is equal to 120 seconds. So Q by T is equal to 30C divided by 120S. That is nothing but 0.25. So the unit for electric current is ampere. Clear, children? So what is electric current? Flow of electric charge. We call that as electric current. So electric charge is measured by means of coulomb. Yes, that is Q, and the time is measured by means of seconds. Now we'll see conventional current and electron flow. So in first diagram, it is given conventional current. So you can, by seeing this, already have studied this circuit diagram in 6th standard. So here if you see this, battery is given. You know battery is having two terminals, positive and negative terminal. Yes, one positive terminal is connected to a bulb, and the other end of the bulb is connected to the negative terminal. So the conventional current flow from the positive to the negative end. So before the invention of electron by the scientist only discovered electron. Before the invention of electron, scientists thought that, yes, the electric current is produced by means of the flow of positive charge. The flow of positive charge is before the invention of electron. So they have decided they explained the flow of positive charge is called electric current. So this type of current we call that as conventional current. But after the invention of electron, they confirmed that electron, that is a flow, the flow of electron is nothing but electric current. So here also the direction, both the diagram is same, but if you observe the direction, the movement of the flow of charges, positive charge in the downward direction, that is from the positive end to the negative end in conventional current, but in electron flow, the flow of electron is from the negative terminal to the positive terminal. So this is the difference between conventional current and electron flow. So electric charges flow from the negative to the positive end in the electron flow, and conventional current flow from the positive to the negative end. Okay children, is it clear now? Now, before the discovery of electron, scientists believed that an electric current consisted of moving positive charges. So this movement of positive charges is called conventional current. But after the electrons were discovered, it was known that the electron flow actually takes place from the negative terminal to the positive terminal of the battery. So this movement is called electron flow. So the conventional current is in the direction opposite to the electron flow. Now we'll see. So each and everything we have to measure, isn't it? So we have to measure electric current. So what is the instrument used to measure electric current? What is the device used to measure the electric current is ammeter. So the diagram for this ammeter is given here. So it is like this. Okay. It is also having positive terminal and the negative terminal. So in which circuit you have to find out the electron flow, that is the measure the electric current, means that positive terminal to be connected to this ammeter. Okay children, so the terminals of an ammeter are marked with positive and negative sign. So ammeter must be connected in series in a circuit. So when I explain this circuit in detail, that time I'll say which is series and which is parallel connection. Okay children, so instruments used to measure the smaller currents in milliampere or microampere range are designed to as milliammeters or microammeters. So what is the measurement means? Electric current can be measured by means of ammeter, that unit is ampere. So 1 milliampere is equal to 10 power minus 3 ampere, in otherwise you can say 1 by 1000 ampere. 1 microampere is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. Minus 6 ampere means in the denominator next to 1, 6 zero should be present. Okay children, so here also an example, that is a problem is given. If 0.002A electric current flow is given through a circuit, then convert the current in terms of microamperes. So we know that 1 ampere is equal to 10 to the power of 6 microampere. So 0.002 ampere is equal to 0.002 into 10 to the power of 6. Okay, so the answer will be 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3. That is 0.002 is nothing but 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So the answer will be 2 into 10 to the power of 3, that is 2000 milliampere. Okay children, now we'll see what is potential difference. So electric charges need energy to push them along a circuit. Okay, suppose if you take some water in the pipe, yes, the pipe, if you open the tap only, water will be flowing, isn't it children? If you stop, yes, if you close the tap, water will not be coming, yes. So you are applying some pressure, yes, to that water, then only it is flowing. Like that, some pressure should be needed for the flow of charge. Okay, for the flow of electric current, then it must need some pressure to push them in a circuit. So water always flow from higher to a ground, lower ground. Similarly, an electric charge always flows from a point at the higher potential to the lower potential. So an electric current can flow only when there is a potential difference. If you apply some pressure on, then only electric current will be flowing from one end to the another end. So the potential difference between any two points in the circuit is the amount of energy needed to move one unit of electric charge from one point to the other. So what is meant by potential difference means high potential minus lower potential. That is the potential difference between two points, yes, from the higher point to the lower point in the circuit is the amount of energy needed to move one unit of electric charge from one point to another point. From one point to another point, the charge should be moving. So how much pressure is applied? Okay, that is nothing but potential difference. So unit of potential difference. So we'll see now unit of potential difference. Did you ever notice the precautionary board while crossing the railway track and the electrical transformer? So what does the word high voltage denotes? So high voltage, the term mentioned in the board, volt, is the measurement of the electric potential difference. So the SI unit of potential difference is volt V. It is represented by means of V. Electric current is measured by means of I. Electric charge is measured by means of small q. So here the SI unit of potential difference is volt. The potential difference between two points is measured by using a device called voltmeter. So electric current can be measured by means of ammeter. Yes, electric potential difference can be calculated using voltmeter. Okay, so here one example is given. Water at the top of the waterfall has more potential energy. Water near the base of the waterfall has less potential energy. So the electric current flows from the higher potential level to the lower potential level is just like the water flow. Next one, electrical conductivity and resistivity. So one diagram is given. First we'll see what is resistance. So the electrical component resist or hinders the flow of electric charges when it is connected in a circuit. So in a circuit component, the resistance to the flow of charges similar to how a narrow channel resists the flow of water. So resistance is the electrical component which will resist or hinder the flow of electric charges. Okay, so the higher the resistance in the component, the higher the potential difference is needed to move electric charge through the component. Resistance is nothing but which will stop the flow of electric charge. Okay, children, so we can express resistance as a ratio. That is, resistance of a component is the ratio of potential difference across it to the current flowing through it. That is R is equal to V by I. V is nothing but potential difference, which is measured in by means of volt. I is nothing but electric current measured by means of ampere. So the SI unit of resistance is ohm. So the greater the ratio of V to I, the greater is the resistance. The next one is electrical conductivity. Okay, so electrical conductivity, conductors means which will allow the electric current to pass through it. So the electric conductivity or specific conductance is a measure of a material's ability to conduct an electric current. It is denoted by the letter sigma. So the unit of electrical conductivity is Siemens per meter, that is S by M. So if you take iron rod, yes, it will conduct the electric current in a high way. In a fast way. Yes, so that is the electrical conductivity sigma. So the measure of the material's ability to conduct the electric current. Okay, children, the next one is electrical resistivity. So electrical resistivity, also known as specific electrical resistance or volume resistivity, it's a fundamental property of a material that quantifies how strongly that material opposes the flow of current, which will stop the flow of current. Okay, so the SI unit of electrical resistivity is ohm by meter. Okay, next one, the material for resistivity and also conductivity is given on table. Example, silver, gold, annealed copper, aluminium, all these are metals. So metals resistivity and conductivity is given. Okay children, then analogy of electric current with water flow. So we are explaining electric current in terms of water flow. So electric current is a flow of electrons through a conductor, like, so the material flow of charges, flow of electrons, only if the material is allowed to pass through them, then only electron will move. So the material which will allow the electric current to pass through them, we call that as the conductors. Okay children, so all metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. So we can't see electrons, however we can imagine the flow of current in a wire, like the flow of water in a pipe. So you can't see the flow of electrons in the electric circuit, but you can observe the flow of water is in the pipe. So only they are explaining, they are comparing. So let us see the analogy of the flow of electric current with the water flow. So water flowing through pipes is pretty good mechanical system, that is a lot like an electrical circuit. So this mechanical system consists of a pump pushing water through a closed pipe. So imagine that the electrical current is similar to the water flowing through the pipe. So the following parts are of the two systems are related. The first thing, the pipe is like the wire. Yes, pipe is like the wire, the in the electric circuit, and the pump is like the battery. Okay, so the pipe is like a wire in the electric circuit and pump is like a battery. So battery will supply electric current, like that in a pipe, if you pump, if you connect the motor, then only water will be moving. Yes, isn't it? So the pressure generated by the pump drives the water through the pipe. So the pressure is like the voltage generated by the battery, which drives the electrons through the electric circuit. Suppose there are some dust or rust that plug up the pipe and slow the flow of water. If there is any material which will stuck the water flow, what will happen? What the force of water will be decreasing. Isn't it children? So creating a pressure difference from one end to the other end of the pipe. In the similar way, the resistance in the electric circuit resists the flow of electrons and creates the voltage drop from one end to the other end. So energy loss is shown in the form of heat across the resistor. Okay children, now we'll see what are the sources of electric current. Already had studied this in 6th standard. So an electric cell. Yes, do you remember that electric cell, electrochemical cells or electric cells? So electric cell is something that provides electricity to different devices that are not fed directly or easily by the supply of electricity. Yes, electric cell is something that provides electricity. Okay children, now we'll see one by one. So this activity zinc and copper electrodes or a light bulb connecting wires and the fruits. Instead of zinc or copper electrodes, you can keep iron nail. It is enough. Okay. And the fruits, that is which is having citrus fruits, can generate electricity. Lemon you can take. Okay. Lemon, orange, apples, grapes and bananas. So set up this circuit like this and note the brightness of the bulb when the circuit is connected to a lemon. So repeat the experiment using the other fruits. What do you infer from this means? Yes, the fruits which you have connected to the bulb produces the electric energy at different levels. So the sources which produce the small amount of electricity for shorter period of time is called as electric cell or electrochemical cells. So the electric cell converts chemical energy into electrical energy. The battery is the cell which you are using in watch, is remote, TV remote, remote car. In that and all, you will be using that cell, no? So the supply of electricity for a short period, we call that as a electric cell. So in addition to electrochemical, we use electrothermal source for generating electricity for the large scale use. So it has two terminals. When electric cells are used, the chemical reaction take place inside the cells, which produce change in the cell. So there are two types of cells. The example for the cells are given. There are two types of cells, primary cell and secondary cell. Yes, primary cell and secondary cell. So primary cell example, dry cell, secondary cells, lithium cylindrical cells, button cell, alkaline cells and automobile battery. So primary cell, that is in our daily life, we are using cells and batteries for the functioning of a remote, toy cars, clock and cell phone. Even though all the devices produces electrical energy, some of the cells are reusable and some of them are of single use. So based on the type of, they are classified into two types, primary cell and secondary cell. So the dry cell commonly used in torches is an example for a primary cell, and it cannot be recharged after use. The cell which cannot be recharged, that is single time use, we call that as the primary cell. Okay, which can be reused, which can be recharged, we call that as the secondary cell. So you can see this picture example. So here button cells, alkaline cell, automobile battery and all, you can recharge it, isn't it? But button cell you cannot recharge it. Okay, watch battery, remote car, remote TV remote, that but in cell phone charger is secondary cell which can be recharged. Okay, so this activity, it is given like that, and that is exhausted. Exhausted means after that it cannot be used. Now we will see difference between the primary cell and secondary cell. It will be useful. Yes, it can be easy for understanding. So first thing, the chemical reaction inside the primary cell is irreversible. That means it cannot be get it back. You cannot recharge it. That is the thing it's given. So in secondary cell, the chemical reaction inside the secondary cell is reversible, and primary cell cannot be recharged, secondary cells can be recharged. So examples of secondary cells are lead accumulator, Edison accumulator and nickel ion accumulator. And secondary cell, it is used to operate devices such as mobile phones, cameras, computers and emergency lights. So examples for simple voltaic cell, Daniell cell and Leclanché cell and dry cell. Examples of secondary cells are lead accumulator, Edison accumulator and nickel and iron accumulator. First we'll see only one example, that primary cell, that is dry cell. So a dry cell is a type of chemical cell commonly used in the common form of batteries for many electrical appliances. So it is a convenient source of electricity available in portable and compact form. Yes, compact and portable means easy to carry. So it was developed in 1887 by A. Sakijo at Japan. So in the picture of a dry cell is given, it is very very important. Anode, cathode and paste of manganese dioxide, ammonium chloride and carbon. So dry cells are commonly used in small devices such as remote control for TV, torch, camera and toys. So a dry cell is a portable form of Leclanché cell. It consists of zinc vessel which act as a negative electrode or anode. The vessel contains a moist paste of sawdust saturated with a solution of ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. So the ammonium chloride act as an electrolyte. So what is cathode, what is anode, what is electrolyte, you will read this in detail in the higher classes. So the electrolyte or the substances, so what is electrolyte mean? Electrolytes are the substances that become ions in solution and acquire the capacity to conduct electricity. So the purpose of zinc chloride is to maintain the moisture of the paste and being highly hygroscopic. So the carbon rod converted with a brass cap is placed in the middle of the vessel. It acts as a positive electrode or cathode. It is surrounded by a closely packed mixture of charcoal and manganese dioxide. So if you break that cell, you can see the black color dust powder, that is nothing but charcoal. Okay children, next thing, the dry cell is not really dry in nature, but the quantity of water in it is very small, as the electrolyte is in the form of paste. So in other cells, the electrolyte is usually a solution. So what is battery? So we have seen cell. So collection of cell, yes, we call that as a batteries. So batteries are the collection of one or more cells whose chemical reactions create a flow of electrons in the circuit. So all batteries are made up of three basic components: anode, that is positive side, cathode, that is negative side, and some kind of electrolyte. So electrolyte is a substance that chemically reacts with anode and cathode. So who first invented battery? One fateful day in 1780, Italian physicist, that is physician, biologist and philosopher Luigi Galvani was dissecting a frog attached to a brass hook. As he touched the frog's leg with an iron scalpel, the leg twitched. So Galvani theorized that the energy came from the leg itself, but his fellow scientist Alessandro Volta believed otherwise. So Volta hypothesized that the frog's leg impulses were actually caused by different metals soaked in a liquid. So he repeated the experiment using the cloth soaked in brine instead of a frog corpse, which resulted in a similar voltage. So Volta published his findings in 1791 and later created the first battery in the year 1800. So the invention of the modern battery is often attributed to the Alessandro Volta. It actually started with a surprising accident involving the dissection of a frog. So I'll stop with this. We'll continue this lesson in the next class, children. Thank you.